We continue inshallah ta'ala today with the explanation of the du'as in the sujood. Very short khatir inshallah that we will all benefit hopefully. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to have a young man who stand by his door at night only in case Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam woke up and needed any help. Rabi'a wanted to be there and serve Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was a very young man, they say 11, 12 years old. So one time Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came out and he told Rabi'a, or he asked Rabi'a a question that every Muslim dream about. He said, Ya Rabi'a, salni. Ask me, Ya Rabi'a, what do you want? So many narrations, and the answer of Rabi'a was, Ya Rasulullah, I want your company in Jannah. I want to be with you in Jannah. And he did not say, I just want Jannah. I want a horse, I want a house, I want a wife. I want your company in Jannah. So what did Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم tell him? أعني على نفسك بكثرة السجود. If you want that goal, like we say here in America, help me help you. If you want that goal of being with me in Jannah, help yourself by performing a lot of sujood. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم named the salat sujood, because there's nothing prescribed in the sunnah. And by the way, we see many people do that. After they finish the salat, he make an extra sajda. Where is this from? After the salat is over, you see some people make an extra sajda and they start making dua in that sajda. This is not prescribed. This is not from the deen. The sujood that Rasulullah is talking about is the sujood in the salat. So Rasulullah named the salat sujood. He's not telling Rabi'ah make a lot of sujood. Here he's telling them make a lot of salat. So the sujood, which was our talk tonight, it was the salat is called sujood. This is how important it is. And Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, sir, the secret of salat is in sujood. And he said, all the things we did before sujood are preparation for sujood. Everything we did before sujood is tahdeer, is preparation for sujood. And it's so good that we do it twice. What are the du'as that Rasulullah ﷺ taught us in the sujood? Like we said before, there are du'as that are common between ruku' and sujood. And there are du'as that are strictly for ruku' and there are du'as that are strictly for sujood. Last time we took the du'as for ruku'. The ones that are common, we said them before, Subhanaka Allahumma Rabbana wa bihamdik, Allahumma ghfirli. This is in Bukhari. Rasulullah ﷺ used to say this in ruku' and in sujood. Subbuhun, Quddusun, Rabbul Malaikati wal Ruh. In ruku' in sujood. Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, strictly ruku'. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, strictly sujood. And we mentioned few that are strictly in ruku'. And today we mentioned two only that Rasulullah ﷺ taught us to say in sujood. Subhanallah. First, before we mention those two du'as, we want to remember, Ya Akhwan, that the closest me and you are to Allah when we are in sujood. The closest to Allah Azza wa Jal when we are in the state of sujood. So Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, when you are in that position, is'al, ask. Ask whatever you want. Allah Azza wa Jal himself said, Fasjud waqtarib. The more you make sujood, the closer you are to me, to Allah Azza wa Jal. Last ayah in Surah Al-Alaq. Make sujood and come close. The more you make sujood, yani salat, the closer you are to Allah Azza wa Jal. So when we are in sujood, make any dua, ya akhi. Any dua. Can I make dua from the Quran? Yes, absolutely. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا we can. What is forbidden in the sujood is to recite the Quran. You don't say in the sujood ربنا آتنا في الدنيا. No, you're making دعاء, you're not making recitation. In the sujood you make دعاء from the Quran. The duas in the Quran are the best duas ever. Then after that the dua is from the authentic sunnah. Can I make dua in sujood in my own language? Now, the scholars said, if you speak Arabic, if you understand Arabic, and you make dua in other than Arabic, your salat is batil. But if it is hard for you to learn a dua in Arabic, and you did your best to learn the dua in Arabic, and you have an emergency and you want to make a request to Allah, they said, go ahead and make dua in any language. But preferably, you have to make an effort to make dua in Arabic. And another group said, you know what? Why don't you memorize the duas that are in general, like رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَا. There's nobody who knows Arabic or who does not know Arabic does not know this dua. And this dua is the most inclusive dua. Or, Allahumma inni as'aluka al-jannah wa a'udhu bika min al-nar. Ya Allah, I ask you jannah and save me from the hellfire. That does not need person to be a master in the Arabic language. And that includes everything that you want. Right? So what are the two duas we will take today, inshallah ta'ala? Number one, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he used to say in his sujood, Allahumma ighfir li dhanbi kullah. دقه وجله أوله وآخرة علانيته وسره. يا الله, forgive all my sins, the small ones and the big ones, the first ones and the last ones, the ones I did in secret and the ones I did in public. يعني there's no more sins left. All kinds of sins, يا الله, forgive them all. That's the first one. Second one, صحيح مسلم, عائشة رضي الله عنها, she said, I used to hear رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say this dua in his sujood. اللهم لك سجد وبك آمنت ولك أسلمت سجد وجهي للذي خلقه وصوره وشق سمعه وبصره فتبارك الله أحسن الخالقين. Beautiful dua. يا الله, to you I'm making sujood. And Ya Allah, I believe in you. And Ya Allah, I submit to you. Sajada wajhi, my wajh, my face made sujood to the one who created it and fashioned it. And the one who gave it hearing and vision. Fatabarak Allah, ahsanul khaliqin. Glorified Allah, the best of creators. Subhanallah. Sujood, you are whispering in the ground. And your voice is heard above the seventh heaven. Sujood is the only ibadah, is the only thing that the more you descend, the more you are elevated. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنك لن تسجد سجد لله إلا رفعك الله بها درجة وحط بها عنك خطيئة أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. There's no time you make any sajda for Allah Azza wa Jal, except He raise you one degree in status and forgive one of your sins. Subhanallah. If someone asks you, where is happiness? Where is happiness? Happiness is when we go to Jannah. Where is Jannah? Is in the A'la. Where is Allah? Allah is on His throne above the Arsh. And the closer you are to Allah, the closer you are to happiness. That's why when I go down on the ground, I am in the lowest level. I'm putting my most honored part of my body on the most humiliated place where I just put my feet. Ya Allah, I only do that for you. And when I am in the lowest position, I say, Subhana Rabbiya al-A'la. You want to go to the A'la? Make a lot of sujood. You want to go to the A'la? Go a lot to the Asfal. Lower yourself in front of Allah. Humble yourself in front of Allah, and Allah will elevate your status. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people who they are in their salat khashi'un.